Welcome back. Over to Sanjay for the big question.
Thank you, Anu, and welcome back. The controversial move to relocate the Annar Centenary Library has been put on hold, courtesy the Madras High Court. A lawyer had challenged the decision through a public interest litigation, and the government now has 6 weeks to respond with its justification. The court order comes as a huge relief to staff and members of the library who distributed sweets as soon as the news trickled in. Our correspondent Salim was present in court for the hearing. The sense of relief was palpable. The Madras High Court stay on relocating this temple of learning is music to the ears of the staff and students.
I'm in favor of the court decision.
Studying nearby school, if they give any projects, I get only information from this library because many books are given free here, and in outer shops it's very costly. So I support the High Court's decision.
High Court today uttar vandu na varavekkanga nijamaga idu nalla vishayam da library ingirukku best na nenaikkanga.
When the public interest litigation challenging the government's decision to convert the Annar Centenary Library into a hospital for children and relocate it on the DPI campus came up for hearing, there were tough questions from the Chief Justice. The Chief Justice asked, "Why do you want to disturb this beautiful building?" And the Advocate General replied, "To make it more beautiful." And the Chief Justice persisted, "But what is the reason?" And the Advocate General retorted, "The Annar Library benefits only the elite in South Chennai. The government wants to make it accessible to all sections of society. The new library would be housed in the Integrated Knowledge Park."
The main argument we raised before the Madras High Court is shifting of a public library located in a particular area would amount to closure of the public library. So when the government intends to shift a library, it intends to close the library. When you want to close the library, necessarily the people of the area should be heard by means of issuance of a public notification.
The High Court has directed the government to file its reply to the objections raised in 6 weeks. With Salim in Chennai, Sanjay Pinto for NDTV Hindu. Time now to welcome our guest in the studio, Rajasekaran, who's a lawyer who's going to file an impleading petition, we are told, who holds a contrary view, and Mr. Radhakrishnan, who successfully managed to get that stay in the Madras High Court. Congratulations, sir, and thank you for joining us in our studio. Rajasekaran, to you first. Government coffers are made up of money, of your money and his money and my money, of taxpayers' money. Why are we trying to squander public money by disturbing an existing facility? When the state is already steeped in debt of more than 1 lakh crore rupees, and you've got freebies also to spend on.
See, first of all, the Honorable High Court has issued a stay. Mm. It has not passed an order. It's a 6 week stay. Mm. So the government, the present government is being voted in by the public, not by you or me or anyone.
We all voted,
and the public have voted, and the government is in the free, their prerogative to take good measures for the upliftment of the downtrodden people of the state. And you cannot allow.
Now why convert an existing world-class facility into something else? See, why it's double expenditure.
I totally agree with you. It is a world-class library, not useful for the common man on the streets of Chennai. It is only for the elite.
Says who?
It is the public. It should be a library to everybody.
You saw those people distributing sweets in that story.
You can understand. They're students from the Anna University.
Like ordinary citizens.
No. They are students from the Anna University. He claims himself to be the student. There is no corporation boy goes into the library. Nobody from the elementary school goes into the library because he fears such a world-class library. It is fit to be a pediatric hospital. My contention is strong.
You're saying it's too imposing.
But due respect to the Honorable High Court's order, my contention, strong contention.
No, you are going to implead yourself in this case.
Yeah, definitely.
Saying, what is your prayer?
My prayer will be put on record before the Honorable Court. But what my contention is, the people of Tamil Nadu want good governance. You should allow the government to function.
All right.
On the contra, every day you cannot hop into anybody's home or office and say you're doing wrong.
All right.
You should allow the people to serve the public.
All right. Your learned friend in the court is going to file an impleading petition. But to what extent, sir, can an administrative action of an elected state government to in fact to substitute one public to substitute a facility with one for one public purpose, a library, with another public purpose, a children's hospital. Is this colorable exercise of power, and isn't this the government's prerogative, as he says?
This is malafide exercise of power.
I strongly object.
It's not only colorable. You know, judicial review is available when fundamental rights of citizens are affected. You have to see, by means of shifting of this library, fundamental rights of citizens or students are affected. This is the issue. What is fundamental right of student or children or the public to have access to education, access to library, access to book,
but
access
in this case,
to knowledge?
The Advocate General, if I'm not mistaken, since you were also present in court, has clarified that they're not going to shut down the library. They're merely going to relocate it. So there will be a minor transition phase. No. And it's not that they're going to leave, shut down the library. It's going to be shut for months on end.
There is a government order passed by the government, the minister, the cabinet ministers, the group of ministers passed an order saying that until and unless we built a new library, this will be in existence.
So
there is a difference between, you know, commencement of a library and closure of an existing library in a particular area. Public Libraries Act 1948 was the first legislation in the country. Tamil Nadu was the pioneer of the library movement. So every area should have a decent library was the aim. So this library is located probably in South Chennai city, right? Kanimara Library in Central Chennai. Other libraries would be located in other places. Every citizen of that area has a right to use the library. So once it is established, when you want to disturb, you have to hear the public. That's the law. The court has given the stay because fundamental rights of the public are affected.
So, but here again, to ask you a very practical level, sir.
Yes.
You're talking about distance and that, you know, South Chennai and North Chennai.
Yes.
But then there are students who travel, 30, 40 kilometers to an engineering college every day.
Yes, this is fine. You know, there are about 80 libraries, the branch libraries in Tamil Nadu, in Madras. Right.
How many of them
all the 80 libraries you can ship to Kanimara? What is this? What kind of action is this?
My learned friend, has to understand. First of all, you should not try. 2005, the same present government passed an order to build a secretariat building in the same place, same venue. DMK came to power. And they said, no, we are not going to build here. We are not going to build on Mount Road, where it is a totally congested area. It's a bottleneck. And you have built a big building, which sounds ridiculous for me. If you keep on playing this, first of all, attitude of the ruler should change. See, some good should happen to the people.
The point, you must not see, forget
every
that
now and then, you also belong to the same fraternity.
You're
also a lawyer. You should understand.
I am now a journalist.
You're a journalist, but you should understand.
With
due respect to the court, I strongly say, you should allow the government to function every day. Cannot file petition.
Allow the moderator to also function now. Let me ask you now. Let me ask you something. There was a time when they wanted to demolish the DGP's, the police headquarters, that beautiful white building opposite the Marina Beach. Okay. Remember that. Jog your memory.
Yeah, yeah.
There was a time when they wanted to pull down the Queen Mary's College. But for a public outcry, but for court's intervention, both these heritage structures would have gone under the hammer.
The 10 people joining and standing in one corner is not public outcry, Mr. Sanjay. Public outcry is not Anna Hazare. Anna Hazare, you know what is happening. Anti Anna Hazare. I'm pro corruption. I'm anti corruption.
You must take off your Congress hat for a minute.
See, the only thing, if you ask me as a congressman, I will say Kamraj rule can save Tamil Nadu. Only Congress can save. That is not my intention.
I thought you were also going to say only Rajasekharan will become chief minister.
It is too much. Asking for too much.
All right. So he's making the point here, but I want to ask you, sir, you have also said in the court, and this is what our reporter told us based on the arguments he heard, that there should have been a sort of public consultation before this. Now, that may be an ideal practice, sir, but is it practically possible? In India, across the state, in various state governments, can everyone keep holding public consultation?
Yes, I will tell you how. It is the constitutional requirement. It is not an empty formality. Suppose you acquire some land, you are issuing a public notice. you have to necessarily issue a public notice when you disturb an existing facility.
In neighboring Karnataka, they have not done that in several places.
No, that's why, because this is the law developing. When an existing facility
land
is
acquisition and
like land acquisition, you already established a library. That library establishes the public fund. It is our money, taxpayers' money. You cannot impose fresh burden on the taxpayer by constructing another building. Nobody prevents this government, you know, from constructing another building close to library. So for accommodating an hospital, there is no difficulty.
Talking of public interest, will you also then file a PIL in the court challenging the petrol price hike?
One could do. You know, economic policy of the government cannot be easily interfered with the courts.
Okay.
But this is not the economic policy.
Fair enough.
This is a public library governed by the provisions of the Public Libraries Act. When there is statutory violation, when there is violation of fundamental right, anybody can approach the court, and the court has rightly stated.
It is not a fundamental, here only I contradict, it is not a fundamental right. It is the rich people's right he is talking about. See, it is a 5-star facility library. It is, I am talking for the common
why
man.
Not, why not have the poor people go into a 5-star facility?
No. Where is the poor people going? You see the building.
Have you been to the library?
No, because of fear, I myself fear to go inside.
You have not been to the library.
No, I'm
very unfortunate.
No, I'm
very,
going.
Very unfortunate.
No.
A person who has not visited the
library
has the courage to come.
No, and talk
to the people.
I'm having all the right and privilege.
On what basis?
Mr.
Radhakrishnan has asked you a valid question. On what basis do you say that only the rich people visit that library?
Rich people means he himself stays, it's a fully well equipped and big, let it be for the hospital. Let the
does it make sense?
Why are you making such a huge cry saying that you should not shift this, every day?
Why don't you understand it? It takes a lot of wasteful expenditure to convert an existing structure into something else.
There is a big scam involved in that, in building that building itself.
Okay.
There is a big scam involved. That is a separate issue which we are going to
That's
take
an allegation you're making. It's up to you.
No. It is a big scam. The whole building. I have nothing against my learned friend. He is a good friend. He has got a good stay. I congratulate him. That's all different. But why you are not allowing the government to function for the interest of the common people? Why you are every now and then saying you are doing a mistake? And the attitude of the qualified should change.
Are you planning to switch camps from the Congress?
Definitely not. My father was a senior congressman. I am a congressman with good intention, interest of the common man. I am talking.
Okay.
See, definitely not.
You're going against your ally, the DMK.
No. What? This is interest of the common people. Only people make every party.
All right, Mr. Radhakrishnan, I want to ask you now.
Yes.
The present Tamil Nadu Chief Minister, during her previous innings, had built world-class stadia, sports stadia.
Yes.
She is known for that infrastructure and all that. She has contributed a lot to the state. Are we trying to prejudge her action with regard to this library?
No, not at all. Even, you know, with regard to Secretariat building, we never spoke even a word.
Okay.
Because Secretariat building to accommodate whichever office, this government likes, let them do. The question is, existing functioning library cannot be disturbed. This is the thing. We don't even say, this library should function in that place. We don't say, in the very building, because it is specially designed for this library. And the public have spent on that crores of rupees, millions of rupees, books are available. It is used by children and the students.
Also swindled by the
this
politicians.
Public money, when it is spent, whether this government or that government has any right to disturb.
Rajasekharan, let me take off from this Radhakrishnan's question. It's a valid point that he's made. Will you then convert a cricket stadium into a hospital?
No, that's what I'm saying. If you want every day, you cannot keep on asking the government, say, you're doing this, you're doing that. See, you should allow the government to function in the interest. See, the people have voted the government.
The local body elections
is the answer for your question. See, the people, if you say the people are unhappy, why they are again in the local body?
I'm not saying they're happy or unhappy. I'm asking you, should the common people, as you're constantly talking, invoking their name, should the common people get caught in the political crossfire?
Definitely not. Common people should have a peaceful, safe living. They should enjoy all the benefits they get from the government for the tax they pay to the government. And they should not be disturbed like this. And they should not be taken for a ride by anybody for that instance. But let the see if they, there is no special multi-specialty children's hospital in Chennai. Hmm. What wrong in starting a multi-specialty children's hospital?
Do it. Do it.
What wrong? What wrong? Why?
Do
why,
it.
Why,
don't why? Demolish this building. Don't convert
this. No, it is not demolishing.
Do
it. It is just changing.
Do
it. It is
that
just
is
changing.
The question of changing. When it is designed for library, why do you try to change it? It is our
library
money.
Doesn't have any design, boss.
It what is this?
No, no, the library is just no, just the infrastructure. Hospital has to be designed.
The architecture of a library is totally different. Can you stitch a suit with a dhoti?
Oh, definitely. That is gross difference. No, this is not.
I will give you an example.
No, you
perfectly agree. Convert an amphitheater into an operation theater.
No, definitely not. See, now library, a centenary world class library, they call. To be turned into an hospital in the interest of the people of Tamil Nadu and their children, what wrong in it? Is it any harm?
Right.
See, they are not going to run a star show. They are not going to run grand gala function. It is a hospital for the poor common man.
No one is disputing the intention behind it.
Sorry.
It's a noble intention to build
a
pediatric hospital, to any hospital for
that
matter.
Kind information, Mr. Sanjay. I am talking on this ground because I am building a hospital near Cholinger.
So you should know that's the kind of infrastructure you need
to
build.
That's why I am saying I am more. I have got the right to talk about it.
Hmm.
Building a hospital is not a easy joke. So when the government is willing to start a specialized children's hospital, we should thank the government. On contra, we are going and accusing the government.
So what is going to be your prayer and your impleading petition? I mean,
I will put it on record. It will be before the honorable judge, and I will put it in my petition.
Maybe you should go and visit the library and do a reality.
No, I visited just for the argument's sake. I said I have not visited. I visited. I just wanted to know the pulse of your attitude. You know.
Okay.
No, he totally reveals one's illiteracy about architecture or about the building.
I'm more qualified. I'm building a hospital, I know.
Then that's what
how
I'm
you
telling.
Can shift.
No, that's what I'm telling. When a building is designed for a library, it should be used for a library.
That is
when
no
it
hard
is
and
not
fast
used,
there
no.
is no hard and fast rule that no. you should do
no.
only this.
No, that's
it is
what
a prerogative of the ruler.
No, that's what the Supreme Court says.
People.
My friend should understand. When a building which is designed for a public purpose is misused or not used for the specific purpose for which it is intended, Supreme Court can intervene and direct the government to use it for the very purpose. That's the later judgment.
Mm.
My friend is not aware of the judgment.
No,
now,
I don't say agree with the judgment. I don't contradict the
there
judgment.
There is a question
but
of agreeing. That's the law of the land.
Why?
You are bound by it.
No, no, right.
My learned friend need not agree.
What is only a 6-week stay?
No.
It is not an order.
No, it is a stay until further orders. He doesn't see the order. He doesn't see the library.
No.
He doesn't see anything.
I've seen the library. I've seen the order.
It's very.
I was present in the court. I witnessed everything. It is a 6 weeks order.
No,
I should. 6 weeks stay. Until further order.
The government is going to file a counter.
We'll wait for those 6 weeks and we will resume this argument after 6 weeks.
Definitely, I am ready. Why?
Till then, we'll stay the argument.
Some people in the opposition want to stop good things happening to the real poor common people.
All right.
Some people in the opposition.
I will conclude. Let the government improve children hospital in Egmore.
Hmm.
Let the government improve Stanley Hospital. Let it improve, general hospital. Let it construct another, super speciality hospital for children anywhere they like. Even close to this building. Don't disturb this library.
All right. Fair enough. Thank you.
Western interest, my friend.
All right. Thank you.
Is saying,
thank
fine.
You very much.
Let us wish happen for 6 weeks alone.
All right. For 6 weeks. Completely out of time. Thank you very much, Rajasekhar. Thank you, Mr. Radhakrishnan, for joining us. That's all the time we have for. But stay tuned because Tamil News, Seidhi Neram, is coming up next with Nirmala Raman.